First of all, I'm not Jørgen Katholm, I'm Kenneth Krogh, and that's because we in Denmark had a cooperation project, green development project about develop diagnostic PCR tests, and it's a co-working project between university people mentioned here and a biotech company where Jørgen and Pajamas were there, but they were not able to come here. So I'm the practitioner in this working team, and I'll try to present some of the detailed things here. We have, in this project, developed a qPCR pneumophore test to detect the most common bacteria and virus. For the bacteria part, we detect the Mannheimia hemolytica, Pastorella multocida, Histophilus somnus, and Mycoplasma bovis. And for the virus part of the test, we have put in 5 target virus, the bovine parainfluenza virus, bovine coronavirus, bovine respiratory syncytial virus, and IBR and BVD. They are in the test in Denmark put together because we have eradicated IBR and BVD. So we have here put them together. Probably in some other country when it's market, it could be in another way. Briefly, we are using this procedure of the qPCR technique. It's actually based on the Mastitis 4 test from the same company, DNA Diagnostic, and it has been used in Denmark in several years. And it's much easier to use the same technique, especially for me in a practice, so we don't have many other steps to use than the same here. The first, when we have a sample, it's treated with a pre-lysis buffer. We use 0.5 milliliter. It could come from tracheal lavage or swabs put in some water or whatever. And then it's pre-lysis in 37 degrees in 10 minutes. We put in lysis to extract the DNA for 20 minutes, 37 degrees and 95 central degrees in 15 minutes. Then there is a spin, and then it's put over in the master mix containing the probe, and then it's run for a qPCR run. All this takes about 3.5-4 hours. The virus part of is a little bit other. That's because most of the virus are RNA virus and has to be changed to DNA by a reverse transcriptase. First, we had to validate the test to see is it good, has it a good specificity. Then it was tested against some known positive strains, and as you can see here, they are all tested positive, positive strains. After that, we figured out more than 200 related bacteria close to which could be found in these samples taken from the airways of cow. And they are all tested negative with a test. So we concluded it had a good specificity. Then they made some dilution test of the genomic DNA. And we can see here for the 4 bacteria, there are dilution down here. And we had the CT values. This is the copy number dilution down. And we have the CT values out here of the run of the PCR. And what we can see here, is that for all bacteria, it has a detection value of around 10 copy numbers of DNA from the bacteria. Then we used spiked samples where we could find actually the number of the bacteria here. We have the number up here. And we have the CT values of the qPCR run. And we also can see here that they are very fine correlated in all of the bacteria here. And we can see it has detected down to around 10 coliforming units of bacteria. And for the virus here, it's the same also, with a detection level of about 10 to 15. Well, And then we have the spiked samples, because then it's important to know, is there a relation between the CT value and the coliforming unit of the bacteria? And this is done in spiked samples. And here we can see a very good correlation in all the bacteria, and we can see here that we have a detection level about down to 10 to 15 per coliforming unit of the Mannheimia and Haemophilus somnus, and that will mean around a CT value of 26 in this test. For the Pastorella multocidae and Mycoplasma, it will end up in a CT value around 30. Then we have tried to compare the result of this quantitative multiplex PCR to cultivation, normal traditional cultivation, and we have here some samples from 65 clinical samples, and what we can see here, this is the positive pneumophore test, and it detects much more of than the positive bacteria culture test. The positive over here for Mycoplasma bovis was made on the official laboratory DTU in Denmark. So it's more sensitive. And we believe one of the reasons here is also that these samples, they are, as in many times in practice, they're taken and then they're posted to a lab. But we run the PCR the same day, and then the culture was made 1, 2, 3 days later, according to the posting system. And we have experienced that many of the bacteria will not be alive and can be cultured in this way, especially the Haemophilus somnus you can see here. We actually can say that because we have another study with 92 clinical samples made by some students where they worked very hard the day and made all the bacteriology, cultivated the first same day. And in this study, we can see that with the 92 here, they are much more similar in detecting. Here, we have the virus part where we compared pneumophore virus qPCR test to another test in the official lab in Denmark, and we can see they're quite not exactly the same, but we detect a little bit more in this test. Here it's the same that it was posted to the official labs. So we think we have developed a good sensitive tests, and we even have shown that there's a good correlation between the CT values and the coliforming units, that would say the level of infection in a way. So we also think that when we go out and use this in practice, we can also say something about the infection level. And this perhaps also have a meaning out there. Here last, I will show you some few cases. This is a typical case where a test has been used in 4 calf from ensotic pneumonia cases. And what we can see here is high, very positive, that means low CT values for BRS virus. There are some Mycoplasma bovis and some Pastorella, also quite high infection grades. This is another case we have here. High infection, very positive for the Mycoplasma bovis and Histophilus. So this is quite different cases. And the last cases I'll show, that was actually from a well-run farm, not with very big problems. We just go out and found 6 sick calves, and we can see nearly no virus here. But there was some bacteria here, mainly some Pastorella, and some Mycoplasma bovis. The healthy cows, we found more bovine coronavirus, and in the chronic cows, there were a lot of bacteria in it. So we believe that here we have developed and validated a good qualitative quantitative qPCR test, which can be used in practice. I'm from a big practice in Denmark, and we are running it ourselves. And this has few handling steps, and it's easy to use. We have a fast procedure, can have the result about 3.5-4 hours later, and we can, in the same test target up to these 9 agents with a good and high sensitivity and specificity. And least but not the best is that it's a cheap test, because earlier in practice it cost a lot of money to make tests for all these agents. Now it can be done for much less money. So we are running it in our herd health management procedure and can use the result for better treatment protocols and vaccine protocols. So we think it's a good thing. Thank you.